We introduced you to a new nest yesterday from a formidable bird, and our story developers noticed something very odd about it. Look at this. This is our green woodpecker. It's got a white eye on one side, which is typical of the species, but on the other side, the eye is brown. It's an example of what we call heterochromia iridum. And it's all to do with the density of a pigment called melanin in the eye. The more melanin, the darker it is. The reason it's dark like that, well, it could be that it's an inherited characteristic. It could be that it's been injured or diseased. And it's a thing that we see quite frequently. Alexander the Great had different colour eyes. Christopher Walken, he's got different colour eyes. So Simon Pegg. And I've got to tell you, a lot of people are probably jumping up and down at home saying, well, David Bowie, he's got different other eyes too. But I checked earlier today, it's not heterochromia, I'm afraid. He's got one pupil which is permanently dilated, so it makes it look like it's a different colour eye. You learn all sorts of stuff on Springwatch, you really do.
So full of information, Chris, aren't you?
Too much information, probably.
I have to tell you that my old headmaster, Mr. Dickens, had that, and it made him look very scary. Sorry, Mr.
Did
Dickens.
Did it make him look a bit like this?
I was really frightened.
Anyway. We all know that everybody needs good neighbours, but unfortunately our woodpeckers haven't got them. These are jackdaws, and yesterday we saw that they're nesting in an old woodpecker nest just above our new woodpecker nest. And we know from Springwatch that they can be a little bit bullish. They can certainly be noisy. They've got their own chicks in that nest that they're feeding. And you can see this is the adult poking its head out. And I'm not quite sure that hole is big enough. Remember, it did make it itself. The woodpecker made it. And it is squeezing out the hole.
Bit like Fawlty Towers, isn't it?
Seriously. Too many pies.
Well, no, you've got woodpeckers at the bottom, jackdaws at the top, and they're bickering all the
bickering.
Time, aren't they?
They are. They certainly are bickering, as we've noticed plenty of times. As I said, the woodpecker is below the jackdaw, and it's putting its nosy nose into the nest. Now, I'm not sure that there's predation going on here. I think it's more intolerance. They find each other a little bit irritating. The woodpecker's feeding the chicks, and look, the jackdaw just comes in and pushes it away.
It is displaying away, though.
It is displaying a bit.
Yeah, a bit of aggression.
But
flicking his wings.
But as I said, I don't think either of them would predate each other's chicks. They'd certainly have a job getting the chicks out of those holes for a start.
Mm.
What do you reckon?
Well, I don't know. Well, jackdaw versus woodpecker?
I think the jackdaw might go for the woodpecker chicks. I thought that the woodpecker might go for the jackdaw, but you're right, you put me right. Greater spotted wood, but green wouldn't.
No.
They're ant specialists, and that's it, isn't
that's
it?
That's it. Great, of course, greater spots will frequently break into nests and steal young, but it's going to be interesting to see what happens here. We'll keep our eye on that, whatever happens.
Well, you know as what, though, we Chris, were, can we... I just tell you, in all the literature that I've read, it's never happened before.
What do you mean, all the literature?
The Ladybird book of jackdaw predation.
All the literature I've read, I resign. Before we go, take a quick look at this. This is our blue tit shortly after they fledged. This was captured by an RSPB volunteer who saw them popping out of our nest box and then rushed down with their camera to get the picture. Pretty fantastic.
That is amazing. Should we have a quick look at our live owl? Because it's there.
There he is.
Oh, it's a bit sleepy still.
Well, I don't know, waking up.
I think it's waiting for one of its 18 feeds of the night.
Look at that. Do you know, they've told me that what they want is people to watch tonight what little grub feeds on and help the story developers. And you can go at hashtag grubsgrub and tell our story developers, watch, tell our story developers what grub actually manages to eat tonight.
It's funny you should say that because I actually did say that at the beginning of the show.
Well, you didn't say about grubs-grub, did
you? No, I didn't say that.
Grubs-grub, you see.
We've had one thing here with the hashtag bitten boomballs or whatever it was. It says here, this is Ryan Atkinson.
That's not bad, actually.
Come on, try
That's
harder.
That's pretty good.
Now, we've got to go now, but don't go away because Unsprung will be right after us and we're going to meet an amazing man, Russell Savory, who back on Tuesday, he got that incredible film about the water bowls.
Also coming up tomorrow, Yolo Williams will be up in Scotland. He's going on a snorkel safari of a sea loch, and very colourful it is too.
Keep your eye on the live cameras. You can watch them online and on the red button. And 7:30 in the morning, you can watch Breakfast with Brett and find out what's happened overnight with all our live cameras.
Fantastic. We've got to go now. But tomorrow night, we'll be back, BBC Two at 8 o'clock. We very much hope to see you.
What's wrong with them?
We'll see you then. Bye-bye for now.